Your life will never be the same.
Don't you know your life will turn around?
Resurrection power is here to take you to.
Beloved, we thank God once again that you've joined us as we are studying strongholds. We're decoding them, and then we will learn how to dethrone them. We are talking about some of those solutions as we are going along, and we thank God that you've joined us. I know you have a stronghold in your life, and I know that this word is necessary for you to prevail against the enemy. One of the weapons Satan uses to build strongholds in our lives is unresolved offenses. Unresolved offenses. How does this work? Something happens to you. You have not learned the simplicity of forgiveness, so you can move on. So you hold it while you pray about it. I've learned that in most cases, when believers don't want to do something, they pray about it. There's nothing wrong with praying. But the Bible says, if you know what to do and you don't do it, to you it is sin. There's nothing to pray. Just do it. Sometimes you feel that you're lacking grace because Satan is there re-energizing and re-irritating the wound. Then in those cases, you ask God for grace by crying out to him. But what happens? If you don't resolve that, then something else happens. Then he adds on top of the old offense. And then while now you are dealing with two offenses, then there's a third occurrence, and a fourth occurrence, and a fifth occurrence, and before long, you become a raging nation, a world of bitterness and anger. Beloved, then strongholds of bitterness will form. There's no way around it. Listen, beloved, Jesus says it's inevitable. Offenses will always be here. Now, let me take a little side journey to help you understand. A spiritual offense is not an emotional offense. We all get ticked off emotionally, and most people dwell in emotional offenses. But spiritual offenses are more sinister. You cause a spiritual offense when you make your sin public. You cause a spiritual offense when you grieve the Holy Spirit. You cause a spiritual offense when you oppose God in someone else's life. Most believers don't know what a spiritual offense is. A spiritual offense occurs deeply when there is dishonor. And those things can really be detrimental. But most times we are caught up with emotional offenses. The indiscretions of other people, the failures of other people, and how they impact us. And it becomes a stronghold. Now remember, Jesus taught us in Matthew 18 that we are all like the servant that owed. I remember my old open Bible, the early ones. These latest ones are not like that. He said, if it was silver, that the debt the servant owed the master was $52,800,000. If it was silver. And that what the fellow servant owed this servant was $44. The master forgave the servant $58 million. and the servant went and put the fellow servant in jail for $44. Beloved, that is the crux of strongholds in our lives. People wound us emotionally, and we forget how grace is extended in our lives. Now, he said that the Lord of that servant was moved with compassion. And many of us are like the old Boy Scout song, I shall not be moved. I'm never moved, no matter. I'm stuck in the same position. I believe the same things. I change nothing. I hold on to things. And the Bible says that tormentors will be released into your life. And there's no way you can come out, God says, except you pay the last farthing. Forgiveness, beloved, is you're out. I know we will get into how to overcome these strongholds, but unresolved offenses have incarcerated so many people. And Satan has trafficked freely, hindered personal prosperity, kept you from receiving your healing, and much, much more. If you want to dethrone these strongholds, do the very simple thing you've known all along. Just forgive. And ask God for the grace to do so. In Jesus' name. Amen. We love you. We'll continue tomorrow. Pastor Chico. Bye-bye.
The Lord is waiting on you. Welcome to resurrection.
Welcome.
The Lord is waiting on you.
Yes, he is, yes, he is, yes, he is, yes, he is.